Hey guys, what's up? It's the Work 8 Breezy here, and in today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys all about the leaked info that we have regarding Season 9 and some of the best theories that we have. Be sure to stay until the end of today's video, because there's plenty of new information that you should know before heading into the new season of Fortnite. First up guys, let's take a look at the first teaser that we got for Season 9, which was posted not too long ago by Epic Games themselves. In this post, we got a sneak peek at one of the skins that's going to be put in the Battle Pass, and a caption as well that reads, "The future is unknown." Now, if you've been following Fortnite even remotely closely recently, then I'm sure that you heard about the unboxing event at Loot Lake, how the community was able to decide which item from a previous season was going to be brought back into Season 8, and presumably Season 9 as well. As we all know, the drone gun was chosen due to it having a majority of the vote, with attack SMG and bouncers being close in second and third place respectively. But that's not the point that I'm trying to make today, because that's something that you already know. No, what I'm trying to emphasize is the importance of this event. I don't know if you realize this or not, but when we went into the bunker at the end of the rune event, we went completely into a different realm outside of normal space of time. The only other time that we have seen this sort of energy was in the end of Season 6 when Kevin the Cube exploded, and Loot Lake was transformed in the process. Everyone thought this was the end of Kevin the Cube and the mysterious energy type butterfly that he brought, but I can tell you with 99.3% certainty that Kevin the Cube was only the beginning and many more creatures from that world are sure to come. I'm not sure if you noticed this or not, but many players were distracted by the massive event and were trying to cast their vote. But beside the massive glowing orb, which resembles exactly what we saw when Kevin the Cube exploded, there was a desk sitting with a mask, pencil, and what looks to be some sort of boombox. Now, there are many theories out there, and some say it's just for laughs, but I think it has a much deeper meaning than to be some sort of gag. I mean, why would the government that's been mining more or less since the beginning of Season 8 have been looking for this bunker? It has to be because they were either looking for the person inside of it or the power that it contained. As we can see, it contained a massive power source because it gave us the ability to go back in time and change the past. And by the way that the desk looks, when everyone arrived, the person that was operating the source of power must have caught wind of what was happening and prepared to make a quick escape. Within recent months, spots such as Dusty, Greasy, Tilted, Reseal, and even Loot Lake have been destroyed or changed in the process. I have a strong feeling that just like how we were able to choose a weapon that came back into the game, that we're going to be able to have an event where we choose which location is going to be restored on the map. Think about it. Why would Epic just randomly destroy Tilted and Retail out of the blue, and now they're releasing teasers about the idea of time travel and how the future is unknown? But hey, let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section, because I really do enjoy hearing all of the ideas, and I want to know what do you think the theme of Season 9 is going to be. Now, before I just go rambling on and sound like a madman, let's take a look over at the skins that were released around the same time of this event. The Dream skin and Luminous skin were released at the same time, and many people just nodded them off as event hype skins. But upon a closer inspection, we can see that their color schemes match that of the first teaser that we got for Season 9. And even the mask that Luminous was wearing is reminiscent of what we saw in the teaser and on the desk that was sitting beside the cube energy source. All I'm saying is that the people would not have gone so far out of the way to make the color scheme of these teasers match the event if there was no significant connection behind it. And continuing with the hidden messages that are in the teasers that we got, upon closer inspection we can see for the first teaser in the background is in the shape of the letter N. It's something that you could have missed yet again from the initial excitement of looking at the image, but let's keep looking forward and take a look at the next teaser that we got for Season 9. This teaser is in the shape of an E, and when you put the two together, you get something that most likely is going to create the word either new or Nexus. This is a highly debated topic. Now, I'm not exactly sure why they chose these letters to be the secret teaser, because there's many things that it could lead into up until the release date. But I'm sure that there's some deeper meaning behind why they chose these letters in order to create some secret word that we're probably going to get on the last teaser, probably on the release of Season 9 this upcoming Thursday. It is interesting to see how creative Epic is getting with these teasers inside teasers, like some sort of teaser inception with teasers instead of dreams, if you get what I'm saying. I remember back in Season 8, combining all the teasers produced the image of the volcano and confirmed the pirate theme that was on the way. At the time, we did not know the role the volcano was going to play. We can see now how it's been responsible for many map changes like the removal of Whale in the Woods and the ultimate destruction of Tilted and Retail. Spelling out a word is definitely a change in how Epic is deciding to do things. It's keeping us on our toes waiting to see what other tidbit of information that they're going to be giving us. I can't say for sure which is which, but I feel pretty confident in saying that they've already shown us both the Tier 1 and Tier 100 skins if the teasers were to follow suit of the ones that we've had in the past. But yeah guys, that's all I have to talk about in today's video. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing, and don't forget to leave a like to show your support, because it really helps me out and lets me know what kind of videos that you guys like to watch. And feel free to let me know down below anything that you have to add to the discussion, because Season 9 is dropping right down on my doorstep, and that might have been something that I forgot to mention in this video. Oh, and fair warning, I did make this video 10 minutes long, but the rest of the video is going to be mainly raw gameplay. The reason for this is the YouTube algorithm tends to promote videos that are 10 minutes or longer more frequently, meaning that it gets more exposure. I felt like, you know, within this video, it was better for me to get straight to the point instead of just trying to go around the subject and wasting your time. But thank you again so much for watching, and feel free to watch the rest of the gameplay in this video.
Just break it down.
Oh my goodness. No. Third parties in this game are real. Like, they weren't this intense before, but like, everybody's doing it. Oh, dang, they both came out.